Travel back in time to the 80s, reliving the advice.
Carpe diem. Seize the day.
The comebacks.
Why don't you take a picture? It'll last longer.
And the technology.
Are you telling me that you built a time machine? Out of a DeLorean?
Because just like you, we're stuck in the 80s.
Can you say stuck in the 80s?
Hey, welcome to Stuck in the 80s. It's your host, Steve Spears.
And Jen with one N.
And today we have some breaking news on the 2020 lineup of the 80s cruise.
I am the monarch of the sea.
Stuck in the 80s is a member of the CLNS Podcast Network. You can find our podcast on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, and the CLNS Media Mobile app. And don't forget to listen to our podcast at the CLNS Media website. You can find it at clnsmedia.com.
So the opening song of today's show is obviously Rome from the B-52s off their 1989 album Cosmic Thing. And if you think it's a deep cut, it's really not. Rome actually made it all the way to number 3 on the charts, spending 20 weeks in total on the Billboard 100 in 1990, so just outside the 80s. But Rome was also nominated for a Grammy for Best Vocal Performance.
Steve, oh, I've got to interrupt you because I know Bradley's not here. But he would certainly remind you, the king of the spreadsheets, that we actually talked about Rome about a year ago, I think. Do you remember this? We were talking about sort of songs to kick off summer, and we tried to pick some songs that wouldn't be at the top of everyone's playlist necessarily, and this was my choice. Do you remember that?
I don't. My memory stinks.
Oh, my goodness.
My memory stinks bad. My short-term memory is just shot. I don't know what that's a symptom of, but it's whatever it is, I have it full-fledged fever of short-term memory loss.
Well, what's funny is I remember mine, and I do not remember yours or Brad's.
I don't even remember doing that show, so there you go. When you do 504 shows, after a while, you start to forget some of the details.
I know. Brad could be like, it was actually show episode number 387 in minute 14, but I do not have that. All I remember is I talked about this song like a year ago.
You know, one of the funny things, and I tell people this from time to time, and it involves you, actually, is when we do shows and I tell stories about things that happened 30, 35 years ago, I feel like I download that information from my brain onto the podcast, and then I can clear that memory space in my brain.
Just clean that cache right out.
Right. So what happens, and it happened on the very first 80s cruise when I met you and your best friend Lucy. I believe that is her legal name.
But yeah, TM.
You had asked me to retell the story of the rum, bags of rum in my pants for the Sting concert. And I started telling it, and I think you stopped me at one point and said, "You're telling it all wrong. Let me just tell it." And I thought,
that sounds like a Lucy move. I'm gonna go ahead and say, I don't remember that either, but I bet Lucy does.
Yeah. And so literally, some of these stories and some of these podcasts that we've done over the years, I downloaded it, I cleared my cache, and I'm moving forward. So that's just the way it is when you get to be 76 years old.
Sure. Well, tell it. You obviously chose this song. It wasn't me. I wasn't the reason you chose Rome. Tell me why.
So the reason we're playing is because the B-52s are among the headliners for the 2020 Voyage of the 80s cruise. And we've talked about it a few times. We've announced the lineup. But here's the big thing. Today, we're going to be able to announce the rest of the lineup for 2020.
You guys, it's really good, you guys. It's really good.
And we'll have an interview with Joey Fairchild, who's the production manager of ECP, which is the company that runs 80s Cruise. So let's get the big news out of the way first.
Do you have a drum roll? I feel like you need a drum roll of some kind.
Okay, insert obligatory drum roll. Bananarama was supposed to be on this cruise, but they dropped out, most likely due to issues with the group. It wasn't the cruise's fault. They dropped out of a bunch of shows that they committed to. But now ECP has announced that Bret Michaels will now be one of the headliners on the 2020 80s cruise. How's that?
Oh, my God! Don't deny.
So other acts that were just announced are Loverboy. They're coming back. They were on the ship 2 years ago. And Grandmaster Flash is coming back.
You could not get enough, you guys.
Yeah, that is huge news. So if you're keeping track, here's the lineup now. B-52s, Bret Michaels, Berlin, Loverboy, Patti Smythe and Scandal, Tony Hadley from Spandau Ballet, Tony Lewis from The Outfield, Dire Straits Legacy, Asia featuring John Payne, Lita Ford, Midnight Star, The Motels, Big Country, The Jets, Annabella's Bow Wow Wow, Katrina from Katrina and the Waves, and Grandmaster Flash. And that's not all. You also have everyone's favorite tribute band from the 80s. Jesse's Girl will be there. Trial by Fire will be there. And here is some more breaking news that nobody knows yet. The dueling piano players, Brian Wilke and Brad Herron, they'll be back on 2020. The solo guitarist, Kevin Hamill, he will be back for 2020. And DJ Christopher J., a.k.a. the drummer for Berlin, who everybody loves his sets as a DJ, he will be back for some sets on the 2020 cruise. And, of course, we can now confirm that Nina Blackwood, Mark Goodman, and Alan Hunter, our favorite MTV VJs, they will all be there on the ship as well.
So here's the plan, everybody. You need to go to some kind of altered state style, like a sensory deprivation chamber for about a week prior to the cruise, because no one is sleeping. I mean, there's just no one is sleeping. Just accept it now. Get, you know, go on this cruise, but no, you will not sleep.
Yeah.
In a good way.
It's amazing because so much of the action does happen late at night. There are some events that don't get kicked off till 11 or midnight.
Yeah, I was nervous about that with this last cruise. The very first night, English Beat was playing at 11:30, and I was like, oh my God, there's start at 11:30. As it turns out, it was not a problem because you are so hyped and so psyched to see everybody and so excited to like be there and be with these amazing bands. Sleep really becomes an afterthought for most people until about day five. Then you start to see a lot of do not disturb signs on doors late into the afternoon, but man, is it worth it?
Yeah, yeah. Naps are necessary. This episode of Stuck in the 80s is sponsored by Skylight. You know, Mother's Day is just around the corner, and if you're like me, you seriously struggle with what to get mom for this annual holiday. In fact, I just talked to my sister on Facebook right before the podcast, and we both said, what are we getting mom for Mother's Day? And I said, don't worry about it. I know about Skylight. Skylight is a photo frame that you can email photos to from any time, from anywhere. I don't know if you can email them from the 80s, but we'll see. It sets up in just 60 seconds. Just plug it in. Use the touchscreen to connect to your wireless network and enjoy. Everyone in the family can just email photos to mom Skylight, and they'll pop up on the frame in just seconds. As always, I have to insert my warnings here to 80s fans around the nation. Please refrain from from scanning in your photos from college in the 80s and sending them to mom. She's not going to appreciate the grainy photos of you drinking your Busch Light. I'm just telling you. I know this from experience. But here's what's important. Skylight is 100% satisfaction guaranteed. If you do not love your Skylight frame, they'll just give you a full refund. That's as simple as it is. But you're not going to need one. You're going to preload your Skylight frame with photos, not beer pics, and then you're going to give it to mom for Mother's Day. Now, as part of a special Mother's Day offer, you can get $10 off your purchase of a Skylight frame when you text STUCK to 484848. That's right, $10 off the Mother's Day gift of your dreams, a Skylight frame. Just text the word STUCK to 484848. That's STUK to 484848. Make mom happy this year with a Skylight frame. So, Jen, the lineup is complete, we think. I mean, you never know. Sometimes they add someone in or something happens. Mm-hmm. I got to believe this is one of the strongest lineups I've seen in a while. I mean, Bret Michaels kind of fills that hair metal niche that's never really been covered in the last 4 years of the cruise.
Yeah, and I think also he has a lot of star power because I am no Poison fan. I'm not a big heavy metal hair person. However, if you'll recall in the... Okay, You probably will recall this because I don't think you've ever talked about it, so it's still in your brain somewhere. But remember that show Rock of Love in the late aughts? I'm pretty sure it was like a VH1 kind of, I mean, it was really terrible, but for some reason I loved it. Like, it was so disgusting and gross. It was kind of like watching the dirt for an hour every week, I think. But he's sort of a personality beyond the music. So I, in a way, like Dee Snider. I know quite a few people who are going to go bananas over that announcement. And I think if they hadn't considered going on the cruise, I think that might actually put it on the map for them is Bret Michaels. And, you know, not to mention Lita Ford and a lot of the others. I mean, here's what I find interesting about this lineup for next year is the diversity of it. Like, it's a really varied kind of, you know, if you're into sort of the more alternative stuff, Big Country, Bow Wow Wow. If you like the Motels, certainly. If you're more of an R&B kind of person, the Jets and Midnight Star. If you like, you know, we were just talking about Hair. If you like Lita Ford, that kind of thing. Like, it just seems like a real interest. It feels like the radio in the 80s. You know what I mean? Like, all over the map musically.
Joey is coming up next. Joey's going to talk about the lineup a little bit. He's going to tell you what's new on this new ship. They've got an ice skating rink, and he's going to tell you how they plan to use it. It's not. I will not don ice skates because I do not want a broken leg. We'll talk about some other surprises, hopefully in store, and then we'll meet you after the interview, and we'll do some seggies. How's that sound?
Sounds good.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's Joey Fairchild from ECP. Hey, Joey, welcome back to Stuck in the 80s.
Steve, how you doing? It's been a minute.
I know. It hasn't even been 2 months since we got off the Celebrity Infinity, and here we are, already talking 2020.
We are already talking 2020. It feels like the last time I actually got to really talk with you was Pop Icon Night on 2019, and now we're talking about 2020.
That was so much fun, by the way, letting Brad, myself, and Jen do the first round of judging for that. That was easily one of my highlights of the trip.
Yeah, you guys did a great job, and picked some really great finalists, and the audience picked the rest of them, and it was a fun night.
Yeah, and people brought their A game as always for Pop Icon Costume Contest. Some amazing outfits.
It was definitely a good one.
The energy, by the way, that I've noticed online on the Facebook groups that revolve around the cruise has been, you know, just out of control lately. I mean, we've still got 10 months to go, and people are acting like the ship leaves in 2 weeks.
It's a little crazy. I mean, it's pretty cool. I mean, we're really, really proud of this past cruise. They're all great, but for some reason, the 2019 one really just gelled, really clicked. We really tried to raise the bar, take it to another level. The guests took it to another level, and that momentum and energy, like you say, is continuing, and everyone is excited and acting like it's 2 months away.
Yeah. I think what was also really great about this last year was the performances. I knew Kenny Loggins was going to have a good night, and he did, and people were just in awe. But Sheila E. just blew it out of the water.
Yeah, there were two surprise ones for sure that I think a lot of people just weren't sure. And it was really unique, but it was Sheila E. for sure, and then Grandmaster Flash, right? Those two were just hands down two of the biggest parties and surprises of the cruise.
And since you bring up Grandmaster Flash, I mean, obviously, we've got to talk about the big news today. The 80s Cruise has announced that Grandmaster Flash will be back. Loverboy will be back. I can't be more excited about that. I can never hear Queen of the Broken Hearts enough times. And then the big one, Bret Michaels. Wow.
Bret Michaels, that's right. Yeah, big news today, and we're excited about all of it. You know, we talked and talked, and everyone unanimously voted, and everyone said, yeah, we got to bring back Grandmaster Flash. The parties were just to another level, so we wanted to bring him back, especially with the new ship and some of the cool areas we have there, so to bring that party back. Like you said, Loverboy, we had them a couple years ago. Fan favorite. They love the cruise. They've been calling us every year to come back, and it just worked out this year to where it was finally like, okay, you know, it's been a couple of years, let's bring them back. You know, they did that piano bar jam, and that's become like something that everyone's asking for, so we've talked to them about that, and they've tentatively agreed to do that as well, so we're excited about that. And then Bret Michaels, a newbie to the cruise, and a fun fact, he's actually never cruised before at all, and he is super excited.
Wow, I had no idea. I would have thought by now for sure.
Nope, this will be his first cruise. He's talked about it. He's had other cruises call him. It's never really worked out with his schedule or the quite the right cruise. And he was super happy to get the call from us. And we're really excited to have him as part of the 2020 cruise.
It's definitely one of those little music niches that maybe hasn't been an opportunity to represent itself in the last 4 years of the cruise. I mean, it's sort of the hair metal scene.
Yeah. You know, I mean, everyone does a little bit of this and a little bit of that. We try to get a little bit from every genre of the 80s. But yeah, he will definitely be bringing a new facet of that style of music to the cruise.
You know, one of the other returning acts, I guess the one who's been there the most number of times, except for Jesse's Girl, of course, is Berlin. And I've always kind of thought Berlin is a perfect play for the cruise because they almost serve like as ambassadors or like sort of informal hosts.
Totally. You know, Terry and Berlin, they've kind of just that. They have become that the official ambassador of the cruise. She's kind of the queen of the cruise. You know, she's everywhere on the ship. It's always nice to have a couple people who have done the cruise, and especially someone like Terry Nunn, who's done it so many times. She knows what to expect. She knows the guests. The guests love it that she knows them. So you see her stop, talk to the guests. They're all hanging out, and it just becomes, you know, a real big family kind of affair out there.
Speaking of family affairs, her husband, who comes with her on every cruise, he's probably almost as popular as she is.
He is. Well, you know, we get him involved with the game shows and all that. And the 1 year they won the newlywed game. So, yeah, he's got his popularity, too.
But speaking of famous husbands, it has to be. I have to ask you this. Patti Smyth in Scandal is playing the cruise in 2020. And Patti Smyth, of course, is married to John McEnroe, the tennis legend. So what's the official word on Johnny Mac possibly joining us?
Yeah, we definitely asked that as well. I mean, when we were doing the deal, you know, they said, look, there's a real good chance that John's going to come with her. He pretty much goes to all of her big shows, and the cruise is fun, and she's excited for it. So if his schedule allows, they were like, you know, be prepared for him to come out. We hope you're ready for that.
Are you kidding me? I'm going to pass out. Man, he was my idol when, you know, when I was younger and playing tennis, man. Wow.
Yeah, of course, you know, he's not confirmed. He's not part of the cruise or anything like that. But, you know, same with us. We're hoping he comes out and is traveling along with her.
Now, you mentioned Brett is a first-time cruiser. And Patty, I know I read in an interview, this will be her first cruise too. Is there something when you approach an artist who hasn't done a cruise before, not even as a performer, but not even done one period in their life, what kind of questions do they ask, or what kind of reassurances do you have to kind of get them to kind of to explain what an amazing experience it is?
Well, it is hard, you know, because they're artists, they're celebrities. So the first thing that goes through their mind is, am I trapped with 2,500 guests, you know, pawing at me and coming at me all the time? So, you know, we try to let them know that, no, our guests, as fun as they are and as much as they're there to party, are super respectful and give the artists their space and free time. And, you know, there's some acts that just won't do it. They just hear the word cruise and have no interest in doing it whatsoever. And that's where, you know, even like a Terry Nunn or Dee Snider, anybody who's been on the cruise before is great, because they actually go back and talk to their friends and talk to the other artists and say, no, it's cool. Come and do it. You know, it's totally cool. In fact, that was, you know, part of the Bret Michaels thing, to be honest, was, you know, he heard from Dee that, no, it's legit. It's cool. They're going to take care of you. The guests are great. So it kind of gave him the sense of comfort that he knew he was walking onto something that was legit.
Now, you mentioned Dee Snider, his role last year, or 2019, which is this year. For some reason, I'm always thinking a year ahead when it comes to these cruises. Yeah. I'm sure you are too. Dee was the host of the 2019 cruise. I've noticed that the 2020 cruise doesn't have a designated host. Is that sort of a feature you're trying to experiment with and just kind of go without for a year or two?
Yeah, you know, the first two cruises, 2016 and 2017, didn't really have a host, and it really was just the 80s cruise. And then, you know, we started going into the down the host road a little bit. We had Rick Springfield, we had Dee, and it's great, but it just can be a different dynamic as well. And so, you know, the new guys and all of us who are involved with putting the cruise together just thought, you know, this year it's really about just the 80s cruise being bigger ship, bigger lineup, more bands, more bars, more party. And it was like, that's really the kind of the theme within the theme, if you will. And it's not really about one artist or a host or anything like that. And so we just wanted everybody to come out and have a good time.
You mentioned the new ship. Obviously, for 2020, it's going to be the Royal Caribbean Explorer of the Seas. I've been on it. It's an amazing ship. But it also offers a lot of interesting new features, one of which is an ice skating rink. And then there's that promenade that runs through the center of the ship. Any idea yet what you're going to do with those venues?
Yeah, I mean, those two venues were definitely kind of the big sellers for all of us to say, yes, let's go to this new ship. The ice skating rink, definitely going to be cool. Throwing on some 80s tunes and watching everyone skate around, that's going to be really cool. And then that venue can then be transformed into a secondary venue, a great place to have parties. Because if you think about it, you've got this area that's big enough to be an ice rink. Now, if we cover the ice, now it's a big area to have a party. We can build a stage, you know, lots of stuff to do there. So excited about that venue. Promenade, hands down, is super exciting. It's, you know, you've seen it. The promenade goes from one end of the ship kind of to the other. It's kind of the heart of the ship. It's lined with stores, bars. It has some of the cabins actually look onto it, you know, kind of like,
oh yeah,
like a Mardi Gras scene. So you can kind of open your cabin or look out the window of the cabin. It doesn't open, but you look out and you're kind of right there in the action. So it's just this really big, cool area. And we plan on doing a lot of parties there. We definitely have a Grandmaster Flash party there. That's where you're going to see, you know, probably the Pop Icon contest. Costume contest is probably going to be through there because we can do a big parade. It's inside. People aren't getting blown around as much. So it would be a fun area to plan some programming. And we actually go see the ship end of May. So the whole team goes over there end of May. We actually have to fly to Europe. That's where the ship is currently. We'll get on that ship, sail for a week, and that's when we're really going to tighten up all the last-minute decor ideas, what we're doing in the venues, design the lighting systems, sound systems, and all that. So when we come back from that, we might have to talk again because I might have some more info for you.
I mean, you still anticipate having some of the traditional things, like there'll still be like an 80s arcade and what else? You still have parties by the pool. That's still something that's in the kind of in the plans.
Yeah, we're playing with everything. This ship actually already has a pretty big arcade on it where most ships don't. And they do have some retro throwback 80s style games in there plus other ones. So we're going to look in that and see what we want to do. There's going to be 80s video games no matter what. We just don't know exactly how we want to do it yet. You know, we typically bring on all the arcade games and we're still talking about that, but we're trying to ramp that up another level as well this year. And definitely you're going to have all the concerts and games and activities out at the pool. Because it wouldn't be a cruise or a vacation, I don't think, without that. And it's got the big LED screen out at the pool as well. So going back to like our first year of 2016, where we brought on LED screens for the pool, we're going to be able to duplicate a lot of that and have just a lot of music videos and movies playing throughout the day as well. So we're excited to bring back that really cool MTV style of spring break.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Poolside again.
Yeah, because I have a special friend now who I promised I'm going to watch a midnight movie with. So on deck. So you got to make that happen for me.
All right, we got
you. You probably already have. The speaking of the Facebook groups and the fervor there, there's a lot of people talking about theme nights and, you know, gosh, how they wish they knew them ahead of time. Is how far ahead do you plan out the theme nights? And is there any sort of insider gossip or feel you can give us for what you might be trying to do differently in 2020?
Yeah, I mean, we're always looking at it when we're on the cruise. We're looking at, do these theme nights work? Do we want to repeat? Do we want to do any ones next year? Anyone who's on the 2018 cruise will remember I actually was talking to some of them that we were going to try to do the horror night in 2019, and we ended up doing that. So yeah, we're planning now, we're thinking now, but we're not going to commit to anything until we get back onto the ship and really check it all out, really do some planning. We don't want to rush it. We want to make sure they're all as perfect as they can be. So they'll be announced later this year. So everyone's just going to have to hold tight a little bit longer. And
now I know,
and they're all going to hit Amazon all at once.
Yeah, I know. I gotta start saving up for that now. Now I know you guys, you know, you peek in on Facebook from time to time, and I know you've encouraged people to offer their feedback and suggestions for the future. How's the feedback so far influenced your plans for 2020?
You know, it's great. We just had a meeting not too long ago about that because we did a survey after the 2019 cruise. They got all the results back. So then they go through all the results and give us all the answers, the good, the bad, everything, because, you know, we want to hear it. We want to always try to improve, always make it better. So we definitely listen. I mean, you know, in 2018, everyone talked about we want more karaoke, more karaoke. In 2019, I don't think at times you could even get away from karaoke. So
there was a lot.
You know, we definitely listen. We listen to all that. Yeah.
Excellent. Fantastic. Well, I can't wait to talk to you again after you get back from the horrible work trip to Europe that's going to be required of you to visit our beloved Explorer of the Seas.
That's right. We're excited about it, and we'll definitely come back and see what kind of insider info we can give you.
Thanks for joining us, Joey. Talk to you soon.
Thanks, Steve. Tell Brad, hey.
There he is, Joey Fairchild from ECP, one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet. And
he's so cool.
He does. He is cool, and he works his butt off every year on that cruise. And we certainly work together a lot during the off season to help each other promote this amazing trip. The thing that I was so happy to talk to him about was the whole, will John McEnroe be on the cruise? Because he was
that is fascinating.
Yeah, he's a hero of mine. He's sort of an anti-hero, I guess, to some degree, but I was super into tennis at that age. It was a really popular sport as the 80s began because you had all those really charismatic personalities in the sport, you know, the Jimmy Connors, the John McEnroes and such.
Right.
So it would obviously be a, you know, a huge bucket list thing for to meet him. So I'm really hoping he makes the trip. But, you know, like they say, last minute.
Right. It'll be interesting. It'll be really interesting, though, because I don't know. Like, I don't know how old he is anymore. I feel like he has probably mellowed out in his older years, is my guess.
I don't know. I watched an interview with him and Patty that was probably taken within the last year or two. And they both have a lot of their New York personality still very much a part of them.
So. All right, so never mind. They're both pretty rock and roll still to this day.
So it'll be interesting. I wouldn't be surprised if he's on the ship, I wouldn't be surprised to see him join her on stage. But joining me on stage right now will be Jen, because we're going to do the Seggies.
What's happening, hot stuff?
By the sound of the gong, it must be time for Mystery Movie Moment. We will play a snippet of a movie from the 80s if you know it. You'll email us and you'll be entered into a contest to win some free swag. Brad would normally be here at this point to confirm said swag. He is, I believe, flying home from Europe as we speak.
So I'll do it for him. So, yeah, I have my list. And I'll put you on it. Just send me your mailing address, your physical mailing address, and I will put it on this list. That's pretty good. Yeah.
Excellent, Brad. Thank you. Pay attention. Here's the mystery clip from our previous show.
Oi, how's you spell holiday?
S-H-I-T.
That's Sid and Nancy.
I love.
I think a lot of times you forget that that's an 80s movie.
I love that movie. that was my choice, just because I don't think we'd done it yet. We've talked a little bit about the soundtrack before, but that movie just really surprised me in the subject matter, but also like the style of it. I just love Alex Cox, and it was a big deal when I was in, you know, eighth grade watching it with all my friends.
Yeah, I think I watched it in college, and it was one of those things. I think I actually watched it twice. I was so into the Sex Pistols at one point in my life that I just really couldn't get enough of it. Since Brad's not here, how about you read some of the winners?
Love to. Winners include James Crabtree, Jeff Rocks from Indiana, Peter Ryan, Alan Titus, Mark Ram, Peter Ryan again, and Tom Korn in Austria.
Pay attention. Here's this week's mystery clip.
My invention. Check it out.
Your invention?
Yes.
Sunglasses?
More than that. They're edible. Check it out.
You're insane!
Oh, come on, taste it.
It's
delicious.
If you know it, email us at podcast@sites.com and tune in soon to find out if you're a winner. The mystical refrain that is Name That 80s Tune. Alas, again, we shall endeavor to play a clip from a song from the 80s. If you can get it right, again, entered into the contest for swag from Brad. Brad, how are we doing on that list?
Great list. List is looking good.
Pay attention. Here's the clip from our last show. That's The Warrior from Patti Smyth and Scandal. Oh,
hard. Hardly anyone wrote in.
Here's the. By now, people should know that I will occasionally put in. If I'm talking about the cruise, if I know I'm going to be talking about the cruise, I'm going to put a clip from a band that's playing on the cruise in the show. But I have been re-listening to a lot of her music lately. I had to write an article for an E! News about her, and I just forgot how much fun they were to listen to.
Yeah, she seems awesome, too. I think she's going to be so much fun.
She was one of my first interviews that I ever did solo for the podcast.
Oh, really?
It was a long time ago. I hadn't been to an actual concert in about 10 years when we started Stuck in the 80s. And there was a big 80s show coming to Clearwater. And it had Rick Springfield, Eddie Money, Loverboy, and Patti Smyth and Scandal. And so I interviewed Patti ahead of time, and then we interviewed Rick Springfield in person backstage. And that was a lot of fun. But she was a lot of fun. If you go back and you can find it, I'll have to find a link to it. You can hear me just kind of like my voice is quivering and I'm really nervous and upset and stuff. I was still very, very new
green
to the whole. We're going to do an interview live with someone you used to worship.
You should do a Throwback Thursday and put that link up.
Oh, I will. That's a good idea. Meantime, you drew the short straw, and you get to read the list of just those couple of winners this week.
Cool. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to read the first half, and then tune in next week for, and I'll read the second. No, I'm kidding. Okay, here we go. I will botch a couple. I'm just warning you. Russ from, okay, I already messed up. Winners include Russ from, quote, Newtown, Fetch in Evansville, Andrew Holler in Cincinnati, Carlos in St. Louis, Irwin with an E, Stephen Cloutier, Lynn with three N's in Nebraska, Robert Stroh, Bernie the Dutch Onion Lindemann from Sydney, Australia, Ann Kohler, DJ in Clinton, Greg Blanchard, Brock in North Dakota, Chip from Maryland, Aaron in Fayetteville, Becky the Rocker Pixie, Jeremy in St. Pete, Dr. Dim, hey Dr. Dim, Gus in Gainesville, Rock the Good Ag, Metalhead Ed, Alejandro Stix Cardosa Solis from Tijuana, Mexico, Stony Stitt, Eric Defrosting in Buffalo, I feel you. Lou, Sweet Lou Grilly. Tommy Duchette in Boston. Moldy Girl from Phoenix. Marie in Bradenton. Joseph Perdue, Donnie 85 and Still Alive. Count Von Falkenstein. Orstein. Dave Parrott, Mark Graham, Peter Ryan, Tim and Toadsuck. Mark Badawi, Kelly from the Deli, Rhoda Collins, Michael Mockrock Hayes, Alan Titus, Dave in Oxford, Dan in Omaha, Tom Korn in Austria, and Steve in Ventura.
Woo! Okay, yeah. So maybe I made it too easy this week. Just means a lot of people know and appreciate Scandal. Go ahead and spin the wheel. Let's find out who's a winner.
The wheel is huge. Here we go.
Oh, nicely done. We're going to find out who wins something from the list that never gets updated. And it looks like it's going to land on Jeff Rocks from Indiana. Okay, yay. Excellent. You are this week's winner. So email us your postal address. And Brad, when he gets back and stops complaining about jet lag, will hopefully put you on the list and we'll get this show started. In the meantime, pay attention. Here's this week's mystical clip. If you know it, email us at podcast@sites.com and tune in soon to find out if you're a winner. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Today, Maria Coletti will make her father's favorite Italian pie for the very first time. An age-old family recipe that includes one rather special ingredient, meatballs. At Pizza Hut, we are proud to introduce our own version of this classic. We call it Preazzo Verona Italian Pie. Perhaps today will be your first time, too.
And we're back. Just a few minutes left. A reminder, if you haven't heard enough about the cruise already, it's going to be on Royal Caribbean's Explorer of the Seas. That's a bigger ship than we're used to. It sails from Miami this year, not Fort Lauderdale like the first four ships, from March 8th through 15th. That's a full week in 2020. And stops will be in San Juan, St. Thomas, Punta Cana, which is in the Dominican Republic, and Labadee, which is sort of a private resort area on a little tiny peninsula in Haiti. But the real fun comes, obviously, from the lineup. We're so happy to have Bret Michaels, Loverboy, and Grandmaster Flash coming back, as well as our dueling pianists, our solo guitarist, and, of course, DJ Christopher J. Each night on the ship has a theme night. Joey talked about those earlier. They'll probably release them this summer, is my guess, as they'll start talking about it then. But that doesn't matter. I mean, you can dress up however you want any given night. God knows I did.
There's also
last year.
Theme days where you just wear the thing you wanted to wear for so long.
Yeah, and then there's always been a VIP T-shirt party where you get like this really cool 80s T-shirt. I have all four of them still.
Fun.
And my shirt from year one is starting to look a little raggedy, but the rest of them are in pretty good shape. And then they throw this huge party by the pool. It's usually on the first at sea day, and so it'll be like all this extra food and all these really fancy cocktails, and they'll have a band on stage and people just go nuts for about 3 hours. That's a lot of fun. And then people take a nap for about 3 hours.
Correct.
So if we hadn't mentioned it before, on this year's cruise, all beverages are included. Any alcohol you want, any liquor you wish. But you can also get $200 cabin credit if you book with the promo code STUCK. So if you're a previous guest on the cruise, your previous guest discount is probably better than the $200 cabin credit. But if you're new to the 80s cruise, and we hope some new fans come this year, use the promo code STUCK and you'll get the $200 cabin credit. Brad and I will be on the ship. We'll be doing big 80s trivia. We'll probably record a live podcast again. I think we're going to actually do trivia 2 times a day now. So if you miss us one time, you get to see us another time. So that means twice the work, but twice the fun.
Twice the swag.
Yeah. But find out more, of course, at www.the80scruise. In the meantime, thanks, Jen, for coming on board and picking up Brad's hat and doing the little dance with me again.
You're welcome. Always so fun.
Yep. And in the meantime, Joey, Jen, myself, and eventually Brad, when he gets off the airplane, we remain here until our next show, hopelessly stuck in the 80s.
Stuck in the 80s is a member of the CLNS Media Network. Special thanks to Check Battery Daily for our theme music. And don't forget to subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, or the CLNS Media mobile app.